Everything in the universe is energy. This includes all life forms on Earth. From the energy that is locked up in the fundamental particles making up these organisms, to the energy that they use in order to continue to exist. Often the case that is done through the consumption of food. However, there is one life form that is slightly unique when it comes to its energy source. While other non-human organisms consume food to allow physiological processes to happen and to develop more biomass, humans, in addition to that, also consume extra biological food. That extra biological food fuels extra biological activities. The collection of these activities is referred to as the world economy. In 2012, humans used around that much energy or extra biological food. To put things in perspective, if you were to take that extra biological food and you were to convert that into actual food energy, then that energy could have supported the existence of 5 billion African adult elephants for an entire year. In essence, what I am right now isn't just a person, but a much larger creature because of my extra biological consumption. However, that's not really a fair assessment given that people consume different levels of resources and energy depending on how they are living. In the United States, your average citizen is more like 2.7 adult elephants. In Bangladesh, your average citizen is more like just an extra person, really. It's not that much. And in Qatar, they're more like 7 adult elephants for each citizen. With that said, can you imagine the impact of creatures that are almost as big as elephants on the environment, especially when there's 7 billion of them? Probably not that much. Assuming that these life forms have manifested themselves the same way life has manifested itself for millions of years by capturing energy from the sun and setting the food web in motion thereafter. But the human organism is not a regular life form. It's highly intelligent and aware, and because of that, it has managed to tap into what is effectively stored sun energy. Previously, regular life forms, non-human life forms, that got more than 99% of their energy from the sun, died, decomposed, got pressurized, and have become a staple of humanity's extra biological diet. You know those as fossil fuels, and in today's world, they form 80% of humanity's extra biological diet. The problem is, if you consume this extra biological food, it has the side effect of releasing bad gases that ultimately disturb Earth's environmental forces and cause ever worsening feedback loops. Add to that problem is that humans have this thing called unlimited wants. And this means that given an infinite amount of energy, an infinite amount of space, and the ability to grow faster than the laws of physics would allow, humans will eventually grow to become larger than the observable universe, and even the entire universe, if it proves to be finite. Now, to be fair, any other organism would have probably done the same thing if given these factors, because it's just part of their natural behavior. However, that's assuming, as I've said, the laws of physics would allow you to do that, but they won't, especially the laws of thermodynamics. These laws and their intersection with human activities, the global economy, called thermoeconomics or biophysical economics, is what will ultimately determine what our future would look like. Now, one part of thermoeconomics is the idea that humanity's extra biological staple food, fossil fuels, will eventually become too expensive to be useful, as in it's going to have a negative energy return on investment. At a certain point in time, to pull one unit of energy from fossil fuels, you're going to need to put more than that one unit of energy to extract this one unit of energy, effectively ending the usefulness of fossil fuels or the extra biological food that we really depend on. 80% of our diet is fossil fuels. And what happens when a food is scarce for an organism? Death, competition, survival until the organism can stabilize itself once again with how much actual useful food is available, which throughout life's history has always been a renewable form of energy. The sun. Yes, at this point in time, in most cases, renewable forms of energy slash extra biological food are not as attractive as fossil fuels form of energy slash extra biological food, because renewable forms of energy tend to have less energy return on investment than fossil fuels. But because of the depletable nature of fossil fuels, that will change. So whether we decide to invest heavily into renewable energy right now or not, it's not really going to matter, because eventually we will have to invest heavily into renewable forms of energy. Now, many years from now, if it turns out that the potential amount of renewable forms of energy slash extra biological food that we could use is less than that of the total energy consumption today, remember 80% of which comes from fossil fuels, then this means humanity's extra biological activities cannot be maintained on the same level that we have right now, and will have to decrease to match the actual amount of extra biological renewable forms of energy that we could get. The interesting thing here is, depending on the severity of climate change and the effects that it could have on the planet, then the potential amount of extractable renewable energy will also change. And if climate change happens in a really bad way, then humanity's extra biological activities, the world economy, will have to decrease even further. The population could potentially decrease to an even further level than before. There is an argument that says in the future we will be able to extract more economic value out of a single unit of energy through technological developments than what we are able to get from that same unit of energy today. The problem is, now you're starting to talk about efficiencies, and that may sound good, but that's not necessarily the case. As I have mentioned in my video, why green is not always so green, when you have created an efficiency in the economy, you are saving energy and resources. But the problem is, because of the human mindset, something called the rebound effect or Jevon paradox happens, and that saving in energy and resources ends up being spent elsewhere within the economy, making the economy grow, and then this economy ends up requiring more resources and energy in order to maintain its larger structure. This is not the solution to humanity's potentially biggest problem. All of this makes it seem as if humans are not in control of their situation, their extra biological activities, the world economy, because of uncontrollable external forces. The most important forces of them all are the laws of physics themselves, which limit humanity's natural desire to want to expand, a behavior shared by other organisms, by how much energy can be utilized. But as I have mentioned, humans are different because they are aware and intelligent. Unlike other organisms, humans understand that they can't keep consuming an ever more growing amount of energy. Humans understand that their current energy consumption behavior, 80% of which comes from unsustainable energy sources, fossil fuels, is causing severe effects on the climate and the environment. Humans understand that they can't keep growing their population and the economy based on an energy source that is depletable and will become eventually less useful than renewable forms of energy. Humans understand that in the future, they may not have as much energy as they do today. Since humanity understands that, then the solutions should be simple. We need to limit our unlimited wants. We need to make sure that these limited wants are supported by energy that is renewable and sustainable. And we need to make sure that we create a self-recycling system in place that uses that renewable energy and the resources supported by this renewable energy the same way life has done since its existence. And if our extra biological activities, the economy, and our biological activities, the population, would have to decline in order to achieve that, then so be it. Otherwise, we're still going to achieve balance between our population, the economy, and how much energy we would have, but we're not the ones who are going to decide how we achieve that. The universe is going to achieve that for us through the laws of physics. It might be through a bunch of slow, steady punches, or it might be through a big, knockout, impactful punch to humanity's face. Either way, what I would like to say is, never has the sentence, pick on someone your own size, been more relevant than humanity's fight against the universe. Thank you very much, and I will see you next time.